on the active. I always love watching Derek and Turk play. You know, Neil will be probably inside there, so all of those guys would be excited to watch play. Now, during that, I'll be praying nobody gets hurt. That'll be the thing, right? And listen, it's a blessing and a curse, in my opinion. Like, it's a blessing to be in this position. It's just tough navigating, you know, wanting to win the game and stop people when you got some different moving parts.
We asked you a few weeks ago about the slow starts defensively.
Yeah.
Now you're a little bit farther down that road.
Yeah.
Is anything you can put your finger on there?
Not really. I will say in this particular game, and I addressed it with the guys on Tuesday, I felt what got us in this game were the third downs. In the first half, they were successful on 7 of 9. Now, I think 2 of those were third and ones. So that leaves us with 5 losses on third and whatever. And there were, in those 5, I watched them on Tuesday with the whole group. It was a discipline thing here and a discipline thing there. One, the quarterback got out, and he probably beat us with his feet. But so those things early in the game on that down are really important, because if you win that and you don't have the undisciplined thing happen, maybe you get them to punt the football, and then maybe the score is a little bit different. Now, I was proud of the way they came in the second half, because I think they were 1 for 7 in the second half, and that was huge. So we got to give the guys credit for adjusting and, right, taking the coaching on the sideline and being able to do what we did in the second half.
Coach, following up on the playtime thing, I mean, how much is it for evaluating, like, what roles for me in 2024, or could it be a situation where some of these guys could work themselves into even, you know, marginal playoff?
Yeah, my mind's not on 2024. Like, I really haven't thought of it that way. Be quite honest with you, I still keep the respect of the people we're playing. I mean, there's guys out there that are good football players we're going against. I'm impressed with what the quarterback can do, the tight end. I mean, the running back is still a really good player. So we're not going to go out there and think this is going to be anything other than trying to get an offense, preventing an offense from scoring points, quite honestly. And the rest of, you know, will there be tape there to look at later on? Yeah, but this is about defending an offense.
You mentioned the tape of you. So is this a day where you experiment because the win-loss doesn't matter? Or is it a day that you hide things?
That's a good question. There'll be a little bit of both. Probably a little bit of both. I mean, I'd be honest, if I have an idea in my head, which I've got a few, now I don't know who we're playing, but I probably won't throw something out there that we think we might use. But and there might be some experimentation in there. Yeah.
Do you do anything that may be different this week, into the year? I know a couple of years ago when, you know, it was a similar situation, you weren't here yet, but Andy let, Matt Nagy do more, stuff like that. Do you have different responsibilities in a game like this for maybe some of your younger coaches and have them do some other things, or do you just kind of keep it regular?
I took the approach this week, did it with the players and the coaches. I mentioned this morning. We're only 10 days away from playing our first playoff game. And so I said to the guys on Tuesday, at that time it was 12 days away, that's quicker than you think. Like, this game's in between, so it feels like it's a little bit longer. But my point to them was, let's stay in your routine. Don't lose your edge. Keep doing the things like you normally do every week. I mean, I use this example. If any of us were going to be in the Olympics next Sunday and we had an individual event we were going to use, a high jump or something, we'd be working our butts off right now. Now, we might take a couple of days off before, but it's no time to stop working at it. So getting back to your question, there were some a little bit different things with the staff, but for the most part, we stayed on the same routine so that we're, you know, when Monday comes, we just get right back on it and roll. And I've asked the players to do the same thing. Like, you know, some of the guys know that they may not play a lot, but to a man, because I asked them to do it in the unit meetings, they're still taking notes on the Chargers. They're just in the routine.
Are you spending any time or energy this week?
I have myself, but it's been later once. Again, I just want to stop an offense that we're playing on Sunday. So
you don't designate anything you're normally do during
well week. Coaches have their certain areas.
Sure.
Every week,
that's a normal thing.
Yeah, and they would, I'm sure I've asked them to do the same thing, but that's off to the side after everything is set for this particular game.
Steve, just wanted to get that extended look at Felix, and you knew when you drafted him he had the hand issue, and And you also knew you had a lot of depth at that position.
And then I think he got to have the groin, too. He had something else that went on, really, because he was out for a long time.
So
yeah.
Has his development kind of been as maybe as expected, even though he hasn't played a lot? And, you know,
I think he's developed well. The other thing I just realized the other day, I was having a conversation with someone, he's still very young. I'm not. You could check it. He might be 22. I don't know if you know Sid, but George is young too. Yeah, we got some young guys there. So, but his develop. I think I've seen him mature and grow in the meetings. I'm always asking guys questions. You know, I give them homework tapes at night and then ask them the next day. And Felix just he's been on it. That tells me something. And I think development. We'll see. It would be nice to see him get some plays this week. See where he's at. But I think we've never had a problem putting Felix in. It's just been more of the fact that George and Mike and Charles have been playing pretty good.
Something in particular you're looking for from him?
Not necessarily. With all these guys that maybe haven't played a lot, I'm looking to make sure that they know exactly what they're doing. You know, they all do your job right. I'll be evaluating mental errors. You know, don't want to see those. That tells me that they've been staying up with the game plan. That'd be a good thing.
Steve, when it comes to Legarius and Trent, with the Pro Bowl coming out, they're not about individual accolades, but still,
yeah.
The amazing season that they've had for you and for the team, is a little bit of disappointment. Just like the NFL just hasn't recognized or fans that recognize.
Listen, I'd be lying if I didn't say I was disappointed. You know how I feel about those guys. It is what it is. I mean, again. Because I know those guys, they're more concerned with the bigger picture. But, yeah, disappointed is a pretty good word.
What about milestones? Are you concerned about, like, Chris Jones getting a half a sack?
I would love for Chris to get that. I think that's always good. We don't let that get in the way of, you know, what we're trying to do, and that being prevent points and win football games. But I hope all those guys get that. I want guys to get Pro Bowls and meet all that. I do. I mean, I would love to have that happen.
Is that your call or is that an Andy?
That's the boss who'll make that decision. He'll, you know.
Thanks, everybody.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate it.